Hello, everybody. I'm happy to see you again. And today I will explain you something out of my experience as a physician who has been 50 years long taking care of people fasting, long-term fasting, 5, 10, 15, 20 days, and confronted sometimes with some side effects we never saw in our clinics that exist since 53. And one of them is gallbladder stones. Since we have about 6,000 persons coming to fast to our clinics during 1 year, I was really interested to know if something like this was happening at our clinics. During the fasting, we practically never saw a gallbladder stone. So maybe afterwards, so since we were not making a systematical follow-up, I decided to review our charts. Yes, I must tell you that in our clinics, many people come regularly. This means more or less once a year or once every 2 years. It's a sort of life hygiene to reset every year, to have a regeneration, a pause where you can just sort out what you do in your life. You can be with other people. This is a very, very healthy holiday. And in case of disease, some of them is treated wonderfully by the fasting. So I went back to our charts since 1953 when the clinic started, and I found 372 patients who have come more than 10 times repeatedly with an average gap in between or time in between of 1.5 years. And so, of course, they put on about 12 years from the moment where they did the first fast to the moment where they began this 10th fast. And I looked in the anamnesis if we could see that these persons had gallbladder stones. And from the 5,793 fasting periods, because each of them had 10 periods, we found in 12 persons an anamnesis of gallbladder stone, which was not related with the fasting. It didn't happen just immediately after a fasting. It was maybe in the course of the year. So at least it was very, very little evidence that a non-protein fasting was causing this type of side effect. By the way, we had these 372 patients. We looked at the women because they're more prone to have gallbladder stones. And we saw that in their case, it was not more than by males. They had no problem with this, although they were having 10 time fasting with a weight loss, which was consequent. You can see on the table that the total group started the first fast in an age about 46, and they ended about 59. Then their weight was relatively stable. But when we analyzed the weight development, we saw that a third of the persons had remained at a lower weight from the beginning of the first fast to the beginning of the 10th fast, although they had been aging 10 years, 12 years, according to the people. So it was a good result because they could maintain a lower weight despite of aging. And then there was a second group which was remaining constant. The weight didn't change in the 10, 12 years. This means that despite of aging, they didn't put on more weight. So we had the impression we could stop a sort of weight gain. And then a third of the patients who, despite of this regular fasting, had put on weight, but not enormously. And most of the time, the people tell us that they didn't put on the weight immediately after the fasting, but about 6 to 8 months afterward, when they have gone back to their usual habits who made them fat. So this is an interesting result because, you know, in humans, having charts, medical charts, on a period of 10 years, this is not common. In our clinic, we have people having fasted in their life more than 50 times. I confess it's not many of them, but it's really striking to see that the human body is made for a yearly fast, because in the time where the people could conserve the food only in their body, in the prehistoric time, for instance, then the people were bound to fast when the sun exposition was low. They had no food. And some scientists even think that humans were hibernating. So a sort of a cyclicity in a normal weight corridor of 10, 12 kilos is not something very uncommon in the human species. Why don't we have gallbladder stones in the Buchinger-Wilhelmy fasting program lasting from 5 to 20 days or more? We could make the hypothesis it's because we don't give protein. We just give a little supplement of carbohydrates, but no proteins. And the protein diets give quite a lot of proteins, 100 to 140 grams a day. This might be the reason. The other reason is maybe that the patients and guests that come to our clinics don't stay long enough to have the phenomenon of gallbladder building. And we cannot say about the weight loss because the people have a very acute weight loss during the time where they fast. So the question is open, but at least in all the studies we do with follow-ups or without follow-ups, we don't see this problem. So just erase that from your head. If you do a fasting, even a long-term fasting, on the right setting with the right program, with a good medical guidance, you have very little chances to have a gallbladder stone. I hope you enjoyed this talk, and we will put in the description the reference to this old article that might interest you. I wish to see you soon, and I wish you a good evening.